Insult us if you wish, said Tor. But the truth is that we came here under recognized rules of protection, and your actions, or the actions of the Bishop of Arkhan, reveal you as a man of no honor, a tyrant without a shred of shame. Cowlis stopped laughing. Count Simon sprayed out the words.
How dare you speak thus to the king? Be silent, or I will sew your lips together.
The king wiped his eyes.
I sent Bishop Levinus to Hedeby last year, in the spring, under a genuine flag of truce, he said,
using a wholly new tone of voice, and Bjarki recognized now that he was truly angry.
He went in good faith to visit the court of Siegfried to discuss peace with the warriors of the north. Both sides agreed no action would be taken during this time, that no violence should be perpetrated by either side.
Carolus paused.
I was away in Italy with my army on most urgent business.
He continued.
Indeed, I have only now returned, but I have been kept well informed of events in these parts in my long absence. And you have no right to claim unfair treatment, in my view. No right at all. When I was engaged in the war in Italy, when my back was turned and Levinus's embassy was still in Saxony, while he was making the long journey home, your master, Widukind, treacherously attacked my new territories west of the Weser, burning Castra, slaughtering my undefended settlers, and taking many slaves.
He paused as if to master his emotions.
While my personal envoy was still on the road home, still under the protection of white flag and shield, your man, Widukind, broke the sacred truce, crossing the border and wreaking havoc among my innocent folk.
There was a sudden, painful silence.
Therefore, I shall not be releasing you this day, Bjarki Bloodhand, since you are a double-damned murderer and oathbreaker, and your master is equally faithless. Nor will I observe the usual protections of a truce. You'll rot in this cell till you die, or till I decide what's to be done with you.